यस
इज इट फाइन नाउ?
यस मैम।
ओके ओके सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई विल अगेन स्टार्ट द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सेम लेक्चर दैट वी डिस्कस्ड लास्ट डे यस्टरडे. सो इन द मीन टाइम यू मस्ट हैव सम फ्रेश आइडिया अबाउट व्हाट वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट वाज लिम्फोमा. द ब्रॉडर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लिम्फोमा इज Start replying me in the chat box so I can move forward and I'll come to know that the students are participating. Okay. Hodgkin and the non-Hodgkin. Very good. The broader classification is the Hodgkin and the non-Hodgkin lymphoma. So Hodgkin lymphoma we'll discuss today, and the most confusing thing is the non-Hodgkin lymphoma that comprises around 85% of the lymphomas. So non-Hodgkin lymphomas are further divided in not precursor and mature. Non-Hodgkin lymphomas are broadly divided into the Hodgkin को तो हमने जो है वो तो एक ही तरह की phenotype है उसकी. ठीक है, बी एंड टी सेल. वेरी गुड. द हॉजकिन लिम्फोमास वो नॉन हॉजकिन लिम्फोमास आर ब्रॉडली डिवाइडेड इनटू द बी सेल एंड द टी सेल लिम्फोमास. देन बी सेल एंड टी सेल ईच ऑफ देम इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू प्रिकर्सर एंड मैच्योर. अच्छा, बहुत ये ब्रॉडर क्लासिफिकेशन दे दिया प्रिकर्सर एंड मैच्योर. अदरवाइज जो क्लासिफिकेशन है आई विल शो यू द चार्ट अगेन कि बी सेल की ही क्लासिफिकेशन इतनी डाइवर्स, इतनी लेंथी. There are so many names to memorize, and then each of them have their own characteristics and treatment. But the good thing is the staging is same. The staging and the diagnostic workup for most of the lymphomas is same. And what is that staging? कैसे करते हैं? Staging is very simple. ठीक है? So it would be difficult for you to write. So I am repeating the staging. If only one group of lymph nodes involved, this is stage one. If two two areas of the lymph nodes but on the same side of the diaphragm are involved, this is stage two. If both sides of the diaphragm are involved, this is stage three. And if it is distant metastasis, it is stage four. Okay. One or two of the students were asking about the benign. They were confused in benign and the malignant in my last lecture. So I'm asking again, is there anything that we can divide lymphomas into benign and malignant? Stage one ko benign kahenge? No, there is nothing. Balki if the lymphoma is confined to some area of the lymph node, this is not benign lymphoma. We want, although it has not metastasized, but it has a potential to metastasize. So this is, we'll call it stage one lymphoma, not benign lymphoma. Although it is confined, but it is a stage one lymphoma, not a malignant lymphoma, not a benign lymphoma. Because if you remember the topic from your first year about the neoplasia, we have certain differences between the benign and the malignant tumor. One of those is the potential to metastasize. The lymphoma has a potential to metastasize. Although it is not metastasizing, it is confined at stage one, it is confined to one group of the lymph node or a single group of the lymph node, but it has a potential, it has an ability to metastasize anytime. And when these lymphoma cells, for example, they were in the cervical lymph node area, they metastasize, they go to some other area, and there would be a stage when the lymph nodes would be exhausted, would be so much crowded, and these lymphoma cells can spill into the blood, and that is called as sarcoma of blood. No, why sarcoma of blood? No, no, we don't call it sarcoma of blood. We call it when it the lymphoma cells say hematopoietic spread of tumor. Hematopoietic spread of tumor. No. दिस इज नॉट द टर्म दैट वी यूज, बिकॉज लिम्फोमा सेल्स उनकी तो अपनी बेसिस जो है वो लाए कर रही है बहरहाल बोन मैरो में, अगर वो सेकेंडरी लिम्फोइड ऑर्गन में है यानी कि लिम्फ नोड में है, दे आर इन द स्प्लीन. यस, ल्यूकेमिक फेज ऑफ लिम्फोमा मुजल्फा आजम, ल्यूकेमिक फेज ऑफ लिम्फोमा. इफ द लिम्फोमा सेल्स, दीज मैलिग्नेंट सेल्स, दे स्पिल इनटू द ब्लड, दिस इज ल्यूकेमिक फेज ऑफ लिम्फोमा. एंड इन सर्टेन लिम्फोमास वी हैव दिस ल्यूकेमिक फेज, वी सी दिस ल्यूकेमिक फेज मोर कॉमनली, एंड दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज सर्कुलेटिंग लिम्फोमास. इसी लिस्ट में से होंगे सर्कुलेटिंग लिम्फोमास दैट आई कैन मेंशन इन दिस लिस्ट, कि ये जो लिम्फोमास हैं दे आर फ्रीक्वेंटली they have circulating lymphoma cells in the blood. They are frequently observed in the blood. One of them is mantle cell lymphoma, follicular lymphoma बहुत मिलता है blood में, hairy cell leukemia, leukemia तो नाम ही है leukemia आ रहा है because it occupies the blood. okay, sometimes and Burkitt lymphoma cells you can see in the blood, hairy cell leukemia, marginal zone lymphoma cells can be observed in blood. Follicular lymphoma is also a circulating lymphoma. Mantle cell lymphoma is also a circulating lymphoma. Lymphoplasmacytic lymphoma, splenic and nodal marginal zone lymphoma. These are the and CLL. These are the lymphomas which are which cells are frequently observed circulating in the blood, and that is circulating lymphomas. But one more thing that I want to mention, that for example, follicular lymphoma is in its leukemic phase, and you got to see some atypical, I should say atypical cells. You, of course, you won't be able to identify just on the basis of morphology. Yes, I am very sure these are the follicular lymphoma cells, but you will see that there is abnormal proliferation of the lymphocytes. Okay, make it more simple. ठीक है, लिम्फोसाइट्स इन फॉर एग्जांपल इन चाइल्ड अप टू द एज ऑफ 2 इयर्स, व्हिच सेल लाइन इज मोर कॉमन, मोर कॉमनली ऑब्जर्व और मोर फ्रीक्वेंटली ऑब्जर्व इन द पेरिफेरल ब्लड, लिम्फोसाइट्स या न्यूट्रोफिल्स? क्लास स्टार्ट रिप्लाइंग मी क्विकली, दीज आर वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चंस. यू have discussed this with Dr. Noor in non-neoplastic proliferation of white cell up to the age of 2 years or 3 years. For example, if it is a child of 2 years and you are observing a peripheral blood film, which cells will be more frequently observed, lymphocytes or neutrophil? Oh my god, no reply. Yes, Muiz Abrar Ahmad, not sure. Lymphocytes, question mark. You are not sure. Neutrophils. Acha. Non-neoplastic proliferations of white cells. Pad liya hai. Lymphoma. We are discussing and we don't know which white cells are more frequently observed. Yes, Google search कर लिया सबने और गलत ही search कर लिया. Actually studying this topic today, bye bye. ये तो बड़ा common है. Lymphocytes are most frequently observed cells. जो बच्चों में percentage होती है 60-65% जो होते हैं वो lymphocytes होते हैं. भाई CBC report, interpretation of CBC का practical है, I think you have. तो उसमें take special care of the CBC count, कि जब WBC count है तो जब differential करते हैं, when we do differential between the neutrophils and lymphocytes in children, we have more percentage of the lymphocytes as compared to the neutrophils. Although commonly in after 2 years or after 3 or 4 years, the most numerous cells are the neutrophils, but in children lymphocytes are more frequent. Okay, Moise, keep doing WBC pathology, and with the help of these lectures, I hope this will be much easier for students like you who take interest in the lectures and the things. I'm sure the things will be easier for you. Okay, so when we talk about we were discussing a peripheral blood film, lymphocytes are more frequently observed. But if you got to see a blood film of a patient who is 65 years, okay, then we can think of, not of course that we will be immediately thinking of the lymphoma, we'll be thinking about the viral infections or tuberculosis, and there are so many things. But if you see a pattern, a monotonous cells, and the lymphocytes are predominant, typical lymphocytes are predominant, they have some morphological features as well that you can appreciate on the basis of morphology that, yes, this is something abnormal going on. So you will raise a query that maybe it can be a lymphoproliferative disorder, because at this age, it is sometimes become difficult to differentiate between the neoplastic proliferation and non-neoplastic proliferation. Just by looking at the lymphocyte or at the count of the lymphocyte, you should have a query in your mind that either this is something non-neoplastic, like this is lymphocytosis because of the reactive changes, or some infection, or it is a neoplastic proliferation. So in that case, you will raise a query of lymphoproliferative disorder, or lymphoproliferative disorder, you will advise them to for the bone marrow biopsy or lymph node biopsy if the patient has associated lymphadenopathy, depending on the clinical history. So I was the reason to explain all of these things, that if the blood film was first observed, of course, the hematologist will be observing the peripheral blood film, and they will raise a query of something like mantle cell or follicular lymphoma or leukemic phase. Or lymphoproliferative disorder, but if it is is it clear? जो आपको डायग्नोस्टिक मटेरियल मिला है ना, उस पर डिपेंड कर रहा है. अगर वो पेरिफेरल ब्लड फिल्म पे डायग्नोज हुआ है तो इट कैन बी अ लिम्फोप्रोलिफेरेटिव डिसऑर्डर. एंड इफ इट इज गेटिंग डायग्नोज्ड ऑन द लिम्फ नोड बायोप्सी, देन यू विल बी मोर श्योर दैट वेदर इट इज मेंटल सेल लिम्फोमा, इट इज फॉलिकुलर लिम्फोमा, बिकॉज आईएससी पैनल विल बी अप्लाइड टू द लिम्फ नोड बायोप्सी एंड नॉट द पेरिफेरल ब्लड फिल्म. But we have other methods for that. If you have so many leukemic cells or neoplastic cells in the peripheral blood, then agar aap peripheral blood se usko diagnose karna chahte hain, then we have a diagnostic modality which is flow cytometry. Agar peripheral blood mein 95% abnormal cells hain, so we'll go for the flow cytometry. Aur usse bhi ye sara panel jo hai ye help out ho jata hai. Okay. Now coming to our topic, which was we were telling you about the leukemic phase of the lymphoma and this long list of the peripheral B cell neoplasms. Okay, isme jo first hai precursor B cell neoplasm, this is ALL, because you I think have understood up till now that this is a stage, that a precursor stage in which the B cells, they acquire neoplastic potential at times when they are residing in the bone marrow, and when they are leaving the bone marrow, if this they acquire neoplastic proliferation after their bone marrow stage, then it can be any of these depending on the stage where they are. Okay, so we have discussed all these things. Okay, हम इतनी डिटेल्स में नहीं जाएंगे कि ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मॉर्फोलॉजी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ लिम्फोमा इट इज, व्हाट वी विल सिंपली अप्लाई गो फॉर द लिम्फ नोड बायोप्सी और द फ्लो साइटोमेट्री. सेम मार्कर्स होते हैं फ्लो साइटोमेट्री पे भी, बस इम्यूनोहिस्टोकेमिस्ट्री सॉलिड टिश्यू पर होती है. ओके, और फ्लो साइटोमेट्री जो है वो लिविंग सेल्स पर होती है. ठीक है, तो दिस पैनल विल हेल्प द हिस्टोपैथोलॉजिस्ट टू डायग्नोज और अ डॉक्टर टू कम टू अ कंक्लूजन of what kind of lymphoma it is. Okay, ये सारी ये pictures हैं, these all pictures are of lymph nodes. अच्छा, so we were on lymphoplasmacytic lymphoma, in which we were saying that B-cell lymphoma that I exhibit plasmacytic differentiation, I explained to you that this is some stage between the morphology would be somewhat between the lymphocyte and the plasma cell. Lymphocyte morphology, the main morphological features of the lymphocyte case, size of an RBC, clumped nuclear chromatin, very scant cytoplasm or virtually invisible cytoplasm, clinical symptoms dominated by hyperviscosity related to the high levels of tumor-derived IgM. Now concentrate on this point. This is lymphoplasmacytic. What reason of low attendance in these lectures? I have no idea. Okay, so clinical symptoms dominated by hyperviscosity related to high levels of tumor-derived IgM. Okay, now concentrate on this line, that hyperviscosity related to high levels of tumor-derived IgM, because these cells are intermediate between the lymphocyte and the plasma cell, or you can say the stage at which the cells, these cells have passed through the stage of germinal center, the antigenic exposure has been done, and now they are ready to leave the germinal center or the lymph nodes. Okay, so they have an ability to produce what? Antibodies. Okay, but important feature when we say about any malignancy, when we discuss any malignancy, so we say that a particular clone of the cell is proliferating. Okay, so these cells will be releasing so many IgM, monoclonal proliferation. Very good, Mahesh Tare. Monoclonal proliferation. Okay, monoclonal proliferation would be taking place here, and these cells, of course, these are plasma cells, are very closely related to the plasma cells, so they are releasing IgM. Which antibody they are releasing? IgM. And one more feature of IgM, jo hamare paas 5 antibodies hoti hain, GAMED. So what are the characteristics of IgM? Distinctive characteristics of the IgM. Largest antibody, heaviest antibody. So because this is the heaviest antibody, largest antibody, pentavalent hoti hai. Okay. So this antibody, because pentamer, okay, very good. So this antibody, because it is acquired, it is so much in quantity in the blood, that's why it is producing a symptom of hyperviscosity, because tumor cells are continuously producing IgM. जैसे monoclonal proliferation, तो एक ही तरह के cells हैं वो proliferate कर रहे हैं और एक ही तरह की antibody release हो रही है बार बार IgM, which is the heaviest antibody. That's why the patient will have the symptoms of hyperviscosity, highly associated with mutations in MYD88 gene. Remember, we have to ask something in the paper. So these mutations are important to remember which lymphoma is associated with kind of mutation. Okay. Now coming to the marginal zone lymphoma. Okay. For marginal zone lymphoma, I'll again explain you the same diagram. The cells are leaving the bone marrow. These are the naive B cells. They are going into the, they are leaving the primary lymphoid organ and they are getting settled into the secondary lymphoid organ for further maturation, for further differentiation, or we can say to acquire antigen identification. Okay, this is the mantle zone. This is the, sorry, this is the marginal zone, this is the mantle zone, and this is the germinal follicle. Okay, these naive B cells are entering into the mantle zone. If these cells, they acquire neoplastic potential at this stage, this is CL, this can be CLL, although CLL arises from these naive B cells also when they are leaving the bone marrow and coming to the lymph node. So CLL ke wo kya ho jate hain, wo phir, these are the CLL variants. Okay, so sometimes CLL arises from this stage or sometimes CLL arises from this stage, but whatever, they are before, or we can say pre-germinal center. मोस्टली क्योंकि इसमें भी स्टेजेस है ना, द सेल हैज जस्ट एंटर्ड द मेंटल जोन, द सेल हैज पास सम डेज और सम टाइम इन दिस मेंटल जोन, सो इफ द सेल्स दे आर एक्वायरिंग द न्यूक्लियास्टिक पोटेंशियल आफ्टर लेट आफ्टर एंटरिंग इनटू द मेंटल जोन, दिस विल बी अ मेंटल सिंबल फॉर्म. ओके, नाउ फ्रॉम द मेंटल जोन इफ दे पास थ्रू दिस स्टेज नॉर्मली एंड दे डोंट एक्वायर एनी न्यूक्लियास्टिक पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू देयर ऑन्कोजीन्स और व्हाट एवर म्यूटेशंस दे हैव, दे विल एंटर इनटू द जर्मिनल सेंटर. एंड दीज सेल्स, हेयर क्या होता है जर्मिनल सेंटर में, क्लास स्विचिंग होती है और क्या होता है, सोमेटिक हाइपर म्यूटेशन होती है. ऑल दीज प्रोसेसेस आर जस्ट टू एक्वायर अ पोटेंशियल टू आइडेंटिफाई नॉन सेल्फ एंटीजन एंड नॉट टू गेट अट्रैक्टेड टूवर्ड्स अ सेल्फ एंटीजन. सो यहाँ पे पॉजिटिव सिलेक्शन होगी, नेगेटिव सिलेक्शन होगी. ठीक है, इफ द सेल एक्वायर द न्यूक्लियास्टिक पोटेंशियल एट दिस स्टेज, इट कैन बी फॉलिक्यूलर लिम्फोमा, इट कैन बी डीएलबीसीएल, इट कैन बी लिम्फोप्लाज्मा सेंट्रोइड लिम्फोमा विच इज अ लेटर स्टेज एट विच द सेल इज मोर हाईली इवेल्युएटेड यू कैन से एंड मोर रेडी टू प्रोड्यूस एंटीबॉडीज. सो इफ दे एक्वायर अ न्यूक्लियास्टिक पोटेंशियल लेट इन द जर्मिनल सेंटर, दिस कैन बी लिम्फोप्लाज्मा सेंट्रोइड लिम्फोमा एंड दिस इज बेसिकली नॉट जर्मिनल सेंटर फिनोटाइप, दिस इज दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल इट पोस्ट जर्मिनल सेंटर फिनोटाइप. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द सेल विल एंटर इन टू द मार्जिनल जोन एंड दिस इज द मार्जिनल जोन लिम्फोमा और द सेल एंटीबॉडी प्रोड्यूसिंग सेल विल बी लीविंग द बोन मैरो, दिस इज द प्लाज्मा सेल माइलोमा. सो इफ द सेल्स दे एक्वायर न्यूप्लास्टिक पोटेंशियल at this stage, this is the marginal zone phenotype. Generally, we call it a name, marginal zone phenotype, which is CD5 negative and CD10 negative. Okay, this is marginal zone phenotype. So, we are here on marginal zone lymphoma, that these are the indolent tumors of antigen primed B cells. Antigen priming ho chuki hai na? Antigen primed B cells that arise at sites of chronic immune stimulation and often remain localized for longer periods of time. It presents primarily in sites such as stomach, gall, breast, GI tract is most commonly involved. Okay, now coming to the extranodal marginal zone lymphoma or mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. Basically, marginal zone lymphomas has three types. You know that we have a lymphoid cell collection in the gut as well. So if the because in the lymphoma what we explained that they can be in the secondary lymphoid organ or secondary lymphoid organs where primarily we have lymph node and a spleen, but what other secondary lymphoid organs we have aur kahan lymphoid cells ki collection hoti hain, malt, yes, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, spleen, good, five stretches, thymus to primary lymphoid organ hai T cells ke liye, five stretches, malt, ye good, aur bas, tonsils, good, would be 280 yes. Okay. So if this the cells are neoplastic proliferation occurring at these sites of mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, so this is also a extranodal means outside the lymph node, extranodal marginal zone lymphoma or mucosa associated lymphoid tissue lymphoma, and this is most commonly associated with Helicobacter pylori infection. Okay, then we have nodal marginal zone lymphoma which occurs in the marginal zone of the lymph node, and then spleenic marginal zone lymphoma which occurs in the marginal zone of the spleen and it is associated with the hepatitis C. Okay, so we have three marginal zone lymphomas: extranodal marginal zone lymphoma, which is associated, which is outside the lymph node and it is in mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, maltoma kehte hain usko. Then we have nodal marginal zone lymphoma, as the name indicates, this marginal zone lymphoma occurring in the marginal zone of the lymph node. And then splenic marginal zone lymphoma that is taking place in the marginal zone of the spleen. ओके नाउ हेयर सेल लुकेमिया, अगर मैं कहूँ हेयर सेल लुकेमिया कैसी फिनोटाइप है, अगेन मार्जिनल जोन दैट द वर्ड दैट वी यूज फॉर द फिनोटाइप ऑफ दिस हेयर सेल लुकेमिया, दिस इज मार्जिनल जोन फिनोटाइप. ओके morphologically distinct very indolent tumor of mature B cell with I don't know the reason why splenic marginal zone lymphoma is associated with hepatitis C, but the probable pathology that is given in books that hepatitis C ke association or jo helicobacter pylori ke association with the myeloma, that when the infections start, you know, hepatitis C is a chronic infection. Similarly, Helicobacter pylori is a chronic infection. So, sometime infective pathology, if it reoccurs and it continues, or we can say injurious agent remain continue or some therapy. So, what happened? Sometime these cells, because of the chronically inflamed state, they acquire a malignant potential. Now hairy cell leukemia, but I'll look for a more specific reason. Kindly mail me this question so I'll reply. Okay, hairy cell leukemia, morphologically distinct very indolent tumor of mature B cell that is highly associated with mutations in the BRAF. This is the gene that is associated with hairy cell leukemia. Uncommon hematological malignancy, presence of hairy cells in the blood is. However, the hairy cells, they come in the blood. In 90% cases, these hairy cells is a circulating lymphoma, frequently circulating lymphoma. That's why it is called hairy cell leukemia. Because the lymphoma cells, they will come in the blood. Okay, and they have a very, very specific morphological features that they are easily identified. But there is the association with the BRAF mutation. Heart rate resistant acid phosphatase positivity, these are the modalities that we use in the diagnosis of hairy cell leukemia. And the, again the histochemistry panel, the immunohistochemistry panel, which is positive for CD19, 20, 22, 11C, 25 and 103. So there is so much confusion with the splenic marginal zone lymphoma and B cell prolymphocytic leukemia. Why there is confusion? Because the morphology of these cells is very much similar to the splenic marginal zone lymphoma cells that is also circulating. Cells, they are circulating in the blood, how they would look like. This is the mantle zone lymphoma, and remember, no one is expert enough to be very, very sure. Yes, I can see the blood film and I can tell, yes, it is mantle zone lymphoma. They can just raise a query of lymphoproliferative disorder. Although अपने कोलीग से और अपने उससे डिस्कस भी कर सकते हैं कि इट लुक्स लाइक मेंटल जोन लिम्फोमा, बट यू कैन नॉट बी, यू नो, यू कैन नॉट गिव एनी स्टेटमेंट विदाउट you know, histochemistry panel or flow cytometry. There are some morphological features that are very helpful to diagnose, but no one can be very, very sure just by looking at their phenotype that yes, these are the mantle zone lymphoma or this is the marginal zone lymphoma or this, this, this. Although CLL gets identified easily, even for CLL, we sort of disease, they will go for the supportive evidences like flow cytometry or the immunohistochemistry panel. So this is the, these are the cells of mantle zone lymphoma. Nucleus is somewhat cleaved in these cells. Cytoplasm is scanned and the chromatin pattern is somewhat clumped. While in marginal zone, cytoplasm is more. There is more abundant cytoplasm, slightly basophilic cytoplasm. Again, the cleaving can be observed in these cells, and they have less clumped chromatin pattern, more fine chromatin pattern. Okay. नाउ दिस इज हेड सेल. दिस इज इजी टू आइडेंटिफाई ऑन द ब्लड सेल बिकॉज दीज सेल्स हैव अबंडेंट साइटोप्लाज्म. Abundant cytoplasm. They have less clump chromatin, sometimes prominent nucleoli, but the most classical feature is the hairy projections. Bilkul fine hair like projections coming out of the cytoplasm like this. Hairy, hairy. That's why it is called as these hairy projections. Okay. These hairy projections. This is hairy cell leukemia. But again, it is sometimes getting confused. It sometimes gets confused with the SLVL. But in SLVL, we have two projections. Cytoplasm is again abundant. Chromatin is more clumped. Remember this, the explanation of the chromatin less clumped, more clumped, comparatively less clumped. These are the subjective observations. Okay. This is SLVL, which has two projections from the cytoplasm, while the hairy cell cells, the cells of the hairy cell leukemia, they have circumferential hairy projections. Okay. How does immunohistochemistry panel seems positive for a certain marker or negative for a certain marker? If, for example, you ordered a certain panel and you have the slide like this, this is negative for that immunomarker. Uske upar slide ke upar likha hoga CD20 or slide SEO. So that means this is CD20 negative. Agar usi slide par same thing is written CD20 and the slide looks like this, brown color all around, this is CD20 positive, but again, it is a rough idea. It is very technical. Sometimes the certain markers have positive cytoplasmic positivity. Certain markers has to be observed in the cells which have, you know, nuclear positivity. Okay. So this is a rough idea about. You will not be asked any question related to this immunohistochemistry panel by showing their images, but this is just to show you an idea about how the positive and the negative panel look like. Differential diagnosis, immunophenotype. This is to summarize that CD5 positive hai to mental cell lymphoma. CD हम क्या बताए थे? CD5 positive, CD10 negative कौन से tumors होते हैं? ये दो. Okay. CLL and mental cell lymphoma. These are CD5 positive, CD10 negative. And how to differentiate between these two? Ab MCL and CLL mein kaise differentiate karenge? CLL mostly 23 positive while MCL is 23 negative. Again, MCL mein kya positive aajega? Cyclin D1 positive. We want to be more sure that if it is mental cell lymphoma or the CLL. So MCL would be CD23 negative, but cyclin D1 would be positive. Or translocation kaun si hai mental cell lymphoma ki? नहीं यार 11-14. ओके नाउ CD5 नेगेटिव एंड 10 पॉजिटिव. CD5 नेगेटिव एंड 10 पॉजिटिव ये कौन से ट्यूमर्स थे? फॉलिकुलर लिम्फोमा, सम सॉर्ट्स ऑफ सम टाइप्स ऑफ DLBCL एंड बर्केट लिम्फोमा. ओके दिस CD5 नेगेटिव CD10 पॉजिटिव इज फॉलिकुलर लिम्फोमा. अच्छा ये CD20 क्यों सब में पॉजिटिव आ रहे हैं? अच्छा पार्टिसिपेंट्स है 117. दोज हु आर रिप्लाइंग आर मोस्टली 3 or 4. नहीं पता 20 क्यों पॉजिटिव आ रहा है? बिकॉज ऑफ बी सेल्स. यस बिकॉज दिस इज अ मार्कर ऑफ बी सेल. तो ये सारे बी सेल लिम्फोमा है तो 20 पॉजिटिव है. ओके देन माल्टोमा. Maltoma, हम बता चुके हैं, दिस इज अ मार्जिनल जोन फिनोटाइप विच इज CD5 नेगेटिव एंड CD10 नेगेटिव. व्हाट अदर ट्यूमर्स आर CD5 नेगेटिव एंड CD10 नेगेटिव? देन देयर इज अ लॉन्ग लिस्ट फॉर प्लाज्मोसिटिक लिम्फोमा. CD5 नेगेटिव, 10 नेगेटिव, SLVL इज CD5 नेगेटिव, 10 नेगेटिव, हेरी सेल ल्यूकेमिया एंड अच्छा, नाउ कमिंग टू द क्रोमोसोमल ट्रांसलोकेशंस कॉमनली एसोसिएटेड विद एक्टिवेशन इन बी मैलिग्नेंसी. दीज आर द ट्रांसलोकेशंस व्हिच आर इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर इन केस ऑफ लिम्फोमा. ट्रांसलोकेशन 11-14 इज एसोसिएटेड विद मेंटल सेल लिम्फोमा, 14-18 इज एसोसिएटेड विद फॉलिकुलर लिम्फोमा. बर्किट की मोस्ट कॉमन ट्रांसलोकेशन इज 8-14. 14 पे क्या होता है यहाँ पर? 14 पे क्या होता है? कल बताया था. अच्छा, इम्यूनोलॉजी में पढ़ा, इम्यूनिटी में एंटीबॉडीज की कैपा चेन, लैम्डा चेन एंड हैवी चेन. कैसे बनती है एंटीबॉडी? हैवी चेन, कैपा, लैम्डा. सो द हैवी चेन इज ऑन, हैवी चेन जीन इज ऑन 14. और टू पे कौन सी होती है? लाइट चेन. टू और 22 पे क्या होती है? लाइट चेन. वेरी गुड. 2 और 22 पे लाइट चेन होती है. लाइट चेन इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, कैपा एंड लैम्डा. किस पे कैपा होती है, किस पे लैम्डा होती है? को जीन कौन सी है? BCL1, BCL2, BCL6. BCL1 इज फॉर मेंटल सेल लिम्फोमा, BCL2 इज फॉर फोलिकुलर लिम्फोमा, एंड BCL6 इज फॉर DLBCL. विच वन इज एंटी एपोप्टोटिक जीन? BCL2. वेरी गुड. अच्छा, अगेन क्लासिफिकेशन, CD19 पॉजिटिव 19 इज अगेन बी सेल मार्कर. CD19 पॉजिटिव ट्यूमर और we can say B cell tumors are again divided into 5 positive 5 negative. ये इतनी बार जो दिखाए जा रहे हैं ना, जस्ट टू मेक यू मेमोराइज दीज थिंग्स, दैट CD19 पॉजिटिव इज B cell पॉजिटिविटी. इट कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू 5 positive 5 negative. 5 positive है तो देर आर टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, 5 positive हैज टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, CLL and MCL. If it is 23 positive, it is CLL. If it is cyclin B1 positive, it is MCL. Then CD5 negative can be divided into 10 positive and 10 negative. If it is CD5 negative and 10 positive, it is follicular lymphoma as shown in the previous picture. And if it's CD5 negative and 10 negative, it can be hairy cell, marginal zone, SLVL, LPL, or so many other things. But LPL and plasma cell myeloma has some other features that help in their diagnosis. Now coming to the plasma cell neoplasm. Is it clear up till now? So participants are 113. ये अब्रार मोइस, ये दो माइलोमा मतलब प्लाज्मा सेल न्यूप्लाज्म कॉमनली एसोसिएटेड विद लिटिक बोन लीजन्स, हाइपरकैल्सीमिया, रीनल फेलियर एंड एक्वायर्ड इम्यून एबनॉर्मलिटीज. Neoplastic plasma cells suppress normal humoral immunity and secrete partial immunoglobulins that are nephrotoxic. Okay, associated with diverse translocations involving the immunoglobulin heavy chain locus, frequent dysregulation and overexpression of cyclin D genes. Okay. Plasma cell myeloma or the multiple myeloma, basically which cells have acquired neoplastic potential? This is plasma cells. Because plasma cells, they become abnormal, they become neoplastic, and the quality of the plasma cell is to release antibody. So if a clone of plasma cell becomes neoplastic, what does it mean? You know, the antibodies are highly specific. First of all, you know that antibodies are highly specific. That means the antibody producing plasma cells are highly specific. One type of plasma cell or one clone of plasma cell is producing स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडी क्या है? क्लोन ऑफ वन टाइप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी, यस सिदरतुल मुंतहा, वन क्लोन ऑफ वन टाइप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी, हैवी एंड लाइट चेन्स आर कंबाइंड। अच्छा, हैवी चेन कितनी टाइप्स की होंगी, लाइट चेन कितनी टाइप्स की होंगी? लाइट चेन ब्रॉडली तो हमारे पास हो गई कैपा लैम्डा, हैवी चेन्स कौन कौन सी है? हैवी फाइव है, मियो, गैमा, वेरी गुड, सही है। तो वन टाइप ऑफ फॉर एग्जाम्पल हैवी चेन, अच्छा हैवी चेन में कितनी डाइवर्सिटी है पता है ना, वीडीजे रिकॉम्बिनेशन, हाउ दे एक्वायर डाइवर्सिटी, एंड अगेन द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द लाइट चेन, लाइट चेन हैव सो मच डाइवर्सिटी, मोर डाइवर्स इज द हैवी चेन, ऑफकोर्स लाइट चेन इज लेस डाइवर्स, बट इवन देन इट इज वेरी डाइवर्स टू आइडेंटिफाई many types of billion types of antigen. So when one type of kappa combines for say for example mio chain, so this is IgM kappa, when combined lambda is getting combined with mio, that means it is IgM lambda. Heavy chain is mio and the light chain is lambda. Similarly, if kindly concentrate because it would be easier for you to understand if you concentrate in this on this point, that if for example kappa gets combined with the G chain, okay, so what happened, what is the result? IgG kappa. If lambda gets combined with the G chain, this is gamma chain, that means IgG lambda. Okay, so we have diversity, IgG lambda, IgG kappa, IgM kappa, IgM lambda, IgD kappa, IgD lambda, IgA kappa, IgA lambda. That means that we are getting more specific. Normally, we say IgG, IgM, IgA, but we, here we are more specific mentioning their light chain as well. Okay. So, if one clone of plasma cell would be proliferating and it is producing one type of antibody, iska matlab hai ek plasma cell jo hai na, wo ek hi tarah ki antibody produce karega. That is, if it is designed to produce IgM kappa, because VDJ recombination has taken place, somatic hypermutation has taken place, class switching has taken place. Theek hai, germinal center mein sara kaam ho chuka hai. So now this plasma cell has a potential to produce, like for example, if it is specific or it is designed to produce IgG kappa, it will keep on producing IgG kappa. Okay, and if this plasma cell acquires neoplastic potential due to the involvement of IgH locus, translocations that involve immunoglobulin heavy chain locus. So what happened? All the neoplastic cells will be producing IgG kappa. Is it mono? Clone has acquired a neoplastic. होगी कोई आईजीजी लैम्डा होगी, ठीक है ना, बट इन न्यूप्लेजिया यू विल गेट अ मोनोक्लोनल प्रोलिफरेशन, ऑल आईजीजी कापा ऑफ सिमिलर टाइप्स, इज इट क्लियर? ओके, नाउ डायग्नोसिस। जी बेटा, क्वेश्चन कर ले अपना, व्हाई इज इट कॉल्ड मल्टीपल माइलोमा, इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड प्लाज्मा सेल माइलोमा, it is also called plasma cell myeloma. This is a category of plasma cell dysplasias, and this is a name, plasma cell myeloma or multiple myeloma can be used interchangeably. Okay, increased proliferation of, why the word multiple? Oh my god, maybe because it is involving multiple organs, that you can see here the clinical manifestations, which is anemia, hypercalcemia, bone fractures, renal failure. Okay, it is involving the multiple organs, maybe increased proliferation of plasma cells in the bone marrow. Okay, M protein, increased proliferation of plasma cells in the bone marrow. अच्छा, ये bone marrow में क्यों plasma cells की proliferation बढ़ रही है? ये तो germinal center से बाहर निकल गए थे ना, huh? Who will answer this question? Sidratul Muntaha, you answer this question. मुइस बिकॉज ऑफ मेटास्टेसिस. नो भाई, मेटास्टेसिस तो वो वहीं होगा ना जहां वो रह रहे हैं, तो ये तो जर्मिनल सेंटर से बाहर थे. ओके, लेट्स मेक द क्वेश्चन मोर सिंपल. व्हाई डोंट, इफ द सेल्स आर लीविंग द जर्मिनल सेंटर एंड इट वॉज शोन इन पिक्चर दे वर लीविंग द जर्मिनल सेंटर, दे वर कमिंग इन द ब्लड, सो व्हाई डोंट यू ऑब्जर्व प्लाज्मा सेल्स इन द ब्लड? नो आंसर. कनेक्टिव टिश्यू में रहते हैं. अच्छा, और कहाँ रहते हैं? हमें न्यूट्रोफिल्स नजर आते हैं, लिम्फोसाइट्स आते हैं. भाई, दे गो बैक टू द बोन मैरो बिकॉज देयर होम इज द बोन मैरो, देयर सेकेंड होम इज द बोन मैरो. दे आफ्टर एक्वायरिंग दिस ऑल स्पेसिफिसिटी एंड यस, अब याद आया, आफ्टर एक्वायरिंग ऑल दीज स्पेसिफिसिटी ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग एंटीबॉडी एंड एंटीजेनिक डिफरेंशिएशन एंड वॉट एवर, दे गो बैक टू द बोन मैरो. They reside in the bone marrow, not in the peripheral blood. Okay, so that's why when they start proliferating, तो वो फिर lymph node वगैरह में proliferate नहीं कर रहे हैं, they start proliferating in the bone marrow. अब वहां से they can come into the blood and the stage is called plasma cell leukemia. Okay, but if they are confined to the bone marrow, this is multiple myeloma and their proliferation it starts in the bone marrow and diagnosis on the basis of the count of plasma cells in the bone marrow, because the plasma cells, normally the count of plasma cells in the bone marrow is 1 or 2%, okay, less than 2%. If their proliferation, their resonance, yes, बाबुल का घर, M protein, 60% IgG, 20% IgA light chain only, okay. M protein is the name given to those abnormal proteins, those abnormal antibodies that are released from these neoplastic clones of the plasma cell. This abnormal protein is not given a name. Normal immunoglobulin is gamma globulin, na? So M protein is the name given to that abnormal proteins, abnormal antibodies, M protein. Clinical manifestations is ki kya hongi? Anemia, because plasma cells are proliferating in the bone marrow. One of the reason of that anemia is the suppression of bone marrow by the suppression of erythroid precursors by the neoplastic proliferation of the plasma cells. Then we have hypercalcemia, bone fractures because of the plasma cells, they are proliferating in the bone marrow, so it would lead to the bone fractures. Then we have renal failure and hypercalcemia. Acha, these two diagnostic features, why renal failure and why hypercalcemia? One region of hypercalcemia is very evident, and that is bone pathologies, okay, that are taking place because of the, yes, excellent, because the malformed antibodies are nephrotoxic. These antibodies, these M proteins will, you know, these are nephrotoxic. They are causing problem in the kidneys. They're getting accumulated there. That's why they are leading to the renal failure. Lab may you will order a CBC, you will have a normocytic normochromic anemia. ESR will be raised because of these proteins. UCE, X-ray, and serum calcium. Extrapolytic bone lesions will be there. Clinical features may anemia, bone pain, recurrent infections. Why? Because the antibodies are produced, but these are abnormal antibodies. So the norm suppression of the normal antibodies are Bells-Jones proteins present in multiple myeloma. Bells-Jones proteins basically light chain proteins hote hain. If the plasma cell clone which is proliferating, it is only producing लाइट चेन एबनॉर्मलिटी, लाइक ओनली लाइट चेन्स आर कमिंग आर फिल्टरिंग थ्रू द किडनीज, और इफ द लाइट चेन्स आर सर्कुलेटिंग इन द ब्लड देन दीज आर बेंजोन्स प्रोटीन्स दैट कैन अकर इन मल्टीपल माइलोमा, सम टाइप्स ऑफ मल्टीपल माइलोमा. ओके, रीनल फेलियर. Now this is how the plasma cells look like in the bone marrow. They have a very classical morphology. They have abundant cytoplasm. My God, neoplastic plasma cells activate the RANK receptor on the osteoclast. Itni pathology. Yes, they activate the RANK receptors on the osteoclast, because of which these osteoclastic proliferation starts increasing and osteoblasts, they get decreased. This is a typical reason, pathological reason for these bone fracture also. Okay, but the most common is that because this is exerting pressure on the bone, because the proliferation is increasing in the bone marrow, but this RANK receptor is more specific pathology. But I intentionally didn't discuss this because it's not very important for you people. There are two nuclei because of cell division. No, I am concentrating on the normal plasma cell morphology, and the normal plasma cell looks like this. Okay, abundant cytoplasm, eccentric nucleus, and a paranuclear halo. अच्छा भाई, क्लास टाइम जो है वो खत्म हो रहा है, तो विल क्विकली गो थ्रू इट. दिस इज द मॉट सेल. This is the variation of the plasma cell, and so many vacuoles are there. This is a binucleated plasma cell because of increased mitosis, or because when abnormal proliferations take place, the morphology gets disturbed because of the increased proliferation rate of the cell. Okay, this is important. This is the monoclonal protein peak in the gamma region. Normally, albumin is high, globulin is less, but here you will get a monoclonal protein peak in the gamma globulin region, which is indicating that some abnormal proteins are produced. This is M protein peak. Normal serum protein electrophoresis would look like this, a dense in the area in the albumin region, and in the gamma region you will get a diffuse area that so many types of gamma globulins are produced. Again, you can see here, and this is a diffuse area of kappa and diffuse staining of lambda. Kappa is stronger than lambda because normally the ratio between the kappa and lambda is 2:1. While see the multiple myeloma patient, this serum protein electrophoresis here, you can concentrate on this gamma region. Normally it is a diffuse band, but here in the patient serum you will get a dense band, dense concentrated band. And when you will try to identify what this band or what this concentration is for, this is G, IgG. The heavy chain is G and the light chain here is gamma, kappa. So you can see the M protein here is, which M protein here is IgG kappa. They take bone lesions. Okay, MGUS monoclonal gammopathy of unknown significance, because this kind of serum protein electrophoresis, although not this type of monoclonal protein peak, can be seen in some asymptomatic patients as well, and they later progress to multiple myeloma at a rate of 1% per year. Then there is a smoldering myeloma, disseminated disease that pursues an unusually indolent course, remains silent for years, and this is extramedullary plasmacytoma in which the plasma cell mass proliferate at some location other than bone marrow. Okay, this is the list for the precursor T cell neoplasm. Take a picture of this. You don't need to remember all these names, but similarly, as we have precursor B cell neoplasm, there is a classification of peripheral T cell neoplasm. The reason why we were concentrated more on the B cell neoplasm, because 85% of NHLs are of B cell neoplasm. Link here if you want to see. I'm sending it to you in your chat. You can copy the link from here. मेरी चैट नहीं ओपन हो रही साथी. Okay, now start with the Hodgkin lymphoma is a type of lymphoma characterized by the presence of RS cells, Reed Sternberg cell. It's of lymphoid lineage derived from B lymphocyte. Previously, I have shown you in the picture that they derive from the germinal center B lymphocyte. And this is associated with EBV infection in 50% of cases. The mechanism is the germinal center B cell they had to go the antigenic exposure. For example, if transforming event occurred here, they get exposed to EBV, they are converted to the RS cells. This RS cell has a very classical morphology. They have abundant cytoplasm. They are binucleated, or we can say two nuclear lobes, and a prominent eosinophilic nuclei in each lobe. And this big cell, this cell with two nuclear lobes and two prominent eosinophilic nuclei, this cell is called RS cell, which is diagnostic for classical Hodgkin lymphoma. What happened, because this RS cell, it releases cytokines and it gets a loss of apoptosis. So these RS cells, they start proliferating and releasing cytokines. These cytokines, they will attack the inflammatory cells, and inflammatory response will take place as a result of the cytokines produced by the RS cells. So you have so many inflammatory cells migrating towards this area. And that's why you get in Hodgkin's lymphoma, you have an inflammatory background, and in this inflammatory background, there are prominent RS cells. Okay, these are the Reed Sternberg cells, and that inflammatory background will contain plasma cell, lymphocyte, eosinophils, histiocytes. Okay, clinical features can present at any age, but is rare in children, has a peak incidence in young adults, male predominance 2:1 ratio, painless, non-tender, asymmetrical, firm, discrete, and rubbery enlargement of superficial lymph node. Basically, the patient would present with lymph adenopathy, which is painless, non-tender, and asymmetrical. 80 to 70% cases may cervical lymph adenopathy, then axillary area get involved in 10 to 15% cases. Okay. 50% patients can present with splenomegaly, and then they have constitutional symptoms like fever, pruritus, weight loss, and profuse sweating. Hematological and biochemical finding that you see in the Hodgkin lymphoma is normocytic normochromic anemia. Then we have frequent neutrophilia and eosinophilia because of the cytokines that are produced by the RS cells. Just what are these cells? Sakit, are you there? Sakit? The chat box open your own. Okay, frequent neutrophilia, eosinophilia, ESR, and C reactive protein are raised, LDH raised. This is the RS cell, that's how it looks like in a lymph node. These are the prominent eosinophilic nuclei. Okay, again, this is the RS cell. This is the abundant cytoplasm, two nuclear lobes, and a prominent eosinophilic nuclei. Hodgkin lymphoma classical is usually CD15 and 30 positive, and that's how the positivity looks like. And you have to see the positivity not in these cells, but in the RS cells. These are the RS cells that are getting stained positive with the CD15 and 30. WHO classification of Hodgkin lymphoma, we divide into the nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma and classical Hodgkin lymphoma. Classical Hodgkin lymphoma is further divided into the nodular sclerosis lymphocyte. Chalo Sakit, mera chat box open nahi ho raha. मेरा तो ओपन ही नहीं हो रहा ना, मैं कॉल ही नहीं ना. हाँ, ऊपर जो दिया हुआ है ना, जिससे हमेशा खोल रही हूँ उसको, जब मैं चैट को क्लिक कर रही हूँ तो मुझे शो नहीं हो रही. हाँ, किसको मिनिमाइज कर रही हूँ? हाँ, चैट बैकग्राउंड में कर रही हूँ, इसको बंद करूँ पहले, इसको बंद करूँ. ठीक है, अपने कहाँ से जाऊँ? ठीक है, अब मीटिंग का बार नहीं आ रहा, अब मीटिंग का बार नहीं आ रहा. अब आ रही है आपको स्क्रीन, नजर आ रही है मेरी? ठीक है, अपने चेक की, ये चैट बैकग्राउंड में चली गई रही थी, मुझे इसके आगे ही नजर आ रही थी, तो बड़ा मुश्किल हो रहा। ओके, मिक्स सेलुलरिटी हॉजकिंस लिम्फोमा एंड लिम्फोसाइट डिप्लीशन हॉजकिन लिम्फोमा, स्टेजिंग अगेन सेम मेथड है, लेबोरेटरी फुल ब्लड काउंट्स कराएंगे, ईएसआर, सी रिएक्टिव प्रोटीन, बोन मैरो स्पिरिट एंड डिफाइन बायोप्सी टू सी द स्टेज, एट स्टेज 4 इट वुड बी इन बोन मैरो, इट वुड बी विजिबल इन बोन मैरो, अदरवाइज ये लिम्फ नोड बायोप्सी पर डायग्नोज होगा। एलएफटी एंड एलडीएच, रेडियोलॉजी चेस्ट रेडियोग्राफ एंड सीटी ऑफ थोरैक्स एब्डोमेन पेल्विस, एमआरआई पेट स्कैन जस्ट टू सी द एक्सटेंट ऑफ द लिम्फेडिनोपैथी, और स्टेजिंग के लिए दिस वर्कअप इज नीडेड। व्हाई? बिकॉज स्टेजिंग मेथड इज सेम एज फॉर नॉन हॉजकिन लिम्फोमा, लाइक वन एरिया ऑफ द लिम्फ नोड इन्वॉल्व इज स्टेज 1-2 ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ डायफ्राम 2, बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द डायफ्राम इज इन्वॉल्व स्टेज 3 एंड डिस्टेंट मेटास्टेसिस स्टेज 4। ट्रीटमेंट इज रेडियोथेरेपी एंड chemotherapy. The patient is stage 1 and 2A. They are given radiotherapy in the treatment of bulky tumor masses such as mediastinal tumor that remains after chemotherapy, painful skeletal nodules. So basically, radio treatment is not very important in pathology, but for stage 1 and 2, we give only radiotherapy, and stage 3 and 4, we have to do cyclical chemotherapy, which is ABVD. But the prognosis, the good thing is that 5-year survival rate is 50 to 90%. So Hodgkin lymphoma is very simple. The important thing is to remember the classification of the Hodgkin lymphoma, that it is divided into the nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma and classical Hodgkin lymphoma. Then classical is further divided into the nodular sclerosis, lymphocyte rich, and the details are given in your book. Yet nodular sclerosis, for example, it is very common in female, and cervical lymphadenopathy is more common than mixed cellularity Hodgkin lymphoma and lymphocyte depleted Hodgkin lymphoma. The thing that identify or to discriminate between the Hodgkin and the non-Hodgkin lymphoma is the RS cell. Okay, this classical RS cell is present in the classical Hodgkin lymphoma. Otherwise, RS cell has many variants as well, like Kuhner cells and popcorn cells, for example, in which only one lobe of nucleus is visible. Okay, so these are the variant of the RS cells that are seen in different subtypes of the Hodgkin lymphoma. But staging and the classification is the main thing. I want to ask one thing: what are these cells which have pink staining? Yes, sorry. चैट बॉक्स तो मुझे नजर ही नहीं आ रहा है। ओके, सो आई एम स्किपिंग दिस स्क्रीन बिकॉज़ आई कैन नॉट सी द चैट बॉक्स विद दिस ओपन स्लाइड्स, एंड आई विल बी सेंडिंग यू द लिंक इन द चैट। यस, दीज आर इजनोफिल्स। Kindly copy this link and watch this video. If you have any question, because the class time is over, you can ask quickly. Or the student who was asking about, I don't remember the name. Madam, is there owl eye appearance? Yes, this is owl's eye appearance. RS cells look like owl's eye. Any other question, you can mail me also. I am sending you my mailing address. Madam, will you teach MPS, MDS, myelodysplastic syndrome, or myeloproliferative neoplasms? Dr. Noor will tell. Dr. Noor will teach you the myeloproliferative neoplasms. SLVL is splenic lymphoma with villous lymphocytes. See, you can ask your questions here. You can mail me your questions and I'll try to reply you. What is SLVL splenic lymphoma with villous lymphocytes? Because the lymphocytes have villous projections, two projections dikhai thi na, so that's why it is called as splenic lymphoma, and the point of start is splenic area usually. That's why it is called as splenic lymphoma with villous lymphocytes. And why these villous lymphocytes?